Hey, what's up everyone? I welcome you once again to one of my tutorials. In one of my previous sessions, I was talking about how you can stream precisely one currency from Binance at the same time. Then later, I made another video where I showed you how you can stream multiple currencies at the same time from Binance. And now, I'm gonna show you how you can stream all of them at once. To achieve this, in the API of Binance, I found this endpoint here. If you use this endpoint, this allows you to stream all of the currencies at once. Or to be more exact, you download all of the currency prices from Binance at once. And this is how it looks like when you try it out. Now I will select all of those that were downloaded and I will paste them into my console. And as you can see, there is 2070 of them. So I decided that I will get the streaming done by simply creating a cron job, which will be repetitively accessing this link and downloading all of the currencies at the same time. For this, I opened a new folder, Python Binance Stream All Currencies at Once. And now let's go create a cron job, which will be downloading all the currencies from Binance at the same time. I will create a new file here. It's gonna be named cron Python, and I will create a new method here, which will be called a job. This job will be, let's say, scheduled for every 5 minutes. That's what I need a scheduler for. I will import one and I will schedule this job at every 5 seconds, let's say, and it will do a job, this job, and it will be running forever. You can achieve it in this way. Let's make him sleep for at least 1 second on every iteration. And for this, we will need to import the time. All right. And now what this job is going to do, it is going to make a call to Binance and save all the data which it downloads. So let's call the next function or the next method, which we will be calling save data. And now let's define save data as a method, which we'll be calling a remote URL. Now we need to load all the data from Binance. So we need to access this URL and download all this data here every 5 seconds or every interval, which is defined in the method called job. I'm usually doing it using the urllib library. So I will import urllib request and also JSON. And using this library, I will request, using the instruction URL open, a URL which I have here, which I used already once to download all the data from Binance. So I will write this one here and I will define it as the so-called URL. And now I will read the data from it using JSON load and decode. Let's also print out the current date time to have an overview at each request when the request was actually made. For this, we need to import another library called datetime. And using datetime library and its datetime now function, we can get the current time printed out on our console. We can also print out the amount of the currencies which we are going to save. If each of these is one row, then we can simply just count the amount of rows which we have, which we gained through JSON loads. Let's call it amount of currencies, and let's get this through the instruction length and data. And as this is a string, I have to use a plus here. As this is a string, I need to convert it into a string first, because using the instruction length, I will just get a number back, and I need to convert this number to a string to connect it with the sentence amount of currencies here. All right, and now let's go iterate through all of the items which we downloaded using the instruction for item in data, and let's print out a symbol. We can see the structure clearly here. Every row which we download has got only two fields, symbol and price. That's why it is pretty easy to go through. So this is the symbol and this is the price. I always copy paste to speed it up. And now let's call our job. I will save it and I will start my streamer. So before I try this out, I need to download some of the libraries which I am using here. So I will use pip to install schedule. All right. And now I will install urllib. All right, I have one already. And I think that's it. So I'm going to run my cron Python now. And you can see I'm downloading the currencies now. There are many currencies added every 5 seconds. I will stop it. And how about let's go write those currencies into a database. As usually, I'm going to create a database Python file. It's going to be called just simply dbpython. And I will import the module sqlite tree here. And I will create a method called initDatabase. initdb. What I will do now is to create a connection using the sqlite tree connect. And now how am I going to call the database file into which the data will be downloaded and stored? I'm going to call it tickers db, because what we are downloading here using the cron job, they are actually ticker prices. I will define a cursor and I will place the cursor at the beginning. And now I'm going to create an instruction which will create a table if the table doesn't exist yet. So I'm not going to drop any existing table or any existing database. This instruction here opens the database if the database file exists, and if not, then it simply creates a new one. And now using cursor and execute, I can create an instruction that also creates a table if it doesn't exist yet. So I will write create table if not exists, and I call it tickers, written in small letters. And now I will create fields there called symbol, price and timestamp. Symbol and price because that's what we are downloading for each of the currencies, but additionally also a timestamp because we want to know when which price for which symbol was actually downloaded, right? So I will create a field symbol, I will declare it as text, then a field price, I will declare it as a real number, and timestamp, and that one I will also declare as a real number. Timestamp is going to be a number, it's not something where the date is stored in a readable value. Now let's gonna commit the changes and close the connection. So this should work. So this should initialize the database. When we call this method from another file, we will get the connection opened pointing to tickers.db at the beginning. We get a cursor. Using that one, we will execute an instruction, create table if not exists. We will commit those changes and close the connection. So let's do this at the beginning of every job. I'm going to call this method in save data and not just one time on the beginning, because it may happen that the schedule is longer, let's say 60 seconds, and at some point you, I don't know, copy the file and delete it, and the whole app would actually stop. That's why let's simply have it with every cron job call or with every scheduled event. And each time we are going to save data, first we are going to check if we have the database, and then if we have it, then we save the data. All right, that's the way it could work. Let's import db as such, and let's first save everything which we have. So this should call this method. Now, before we are going to iterate through the data, we will simply open a connection and we do it using SQLite tree again. So we will import SQLite tree. I have to say again, SQLite tree is part of Python. So I will call SQLite tree connect to tickers.db. And now let's get a cursor. And now instead of these two lines here, I will remark them. I will write cursor execute. And now I will insert the values into the database. I will do it using the instruction insert into tickers. And I'm going to insert the values, which I will describe using a question mark, three question marks, because I'm going to save three values into my database. I'm going to save item symbol. Then right after it, I'm going to save item price. And right after it, I'm going to use the time instruction to get the timestamp, and I'm going to save the timestamp. So that's how you get current timestamp defined. And once all of this is done, I will commit all the changes and I will close the connection. And that's pretty much it. I will delete these two lines here. They are not necessary anymore. And now I'm only going to print out the current time and how many currencies were downloaded at that time. And that's it. Now we should see every 3 seconds an update about this. All right. Now let's start the Python cron job that we just built again. And what we should see here is a tickers.db appearing once we did everything really correctly. Python, cron Python, and it works. So we can see the current time is being written down and also the currencies which he's loading and saving into our database. the database is getting bigger and bigger with every download. I will close it now. And what I would like to do now is to read all this data, right? So let's create a data reader as a new file. All right, this would be my new data reader. And let's import sqlite3 once again. SQLite3 is extremely important for us. And let's call the method which we are going to call here, read all. And now let's create the same connection as before. I will copy paste this one from the cron job. Let's also create the same cursor as before. And now let's select everything from the database and from the table tickers. Let's order it by a symbol and let's print out every row. For this, we can use the instruction cursor execute, select all from tickers and order by symbol, and now to iterate every row. For this, let's go through every row using the for instruction. For row in cursor execute, select everything from tickers, and here I have a typo, order by symbol. All right, now let's print the row. This should work nice. And then let's close the connection to make sure that it doesn't remain open. And now let's read all there is. So this is just the simplest example that there is. You will for sure find a way how to analyze your data in more precise way. And this is just to show how it could all work. And now in my console, I will call the data reader. And there it is. There is all the data which I just downloaded from Binance. And here we can see how many times I actually ran the cron job. As many times as one symbol is repeating, as many times I managed to run my cron job. And that's it. That's how you can download 2070 or more currencies from Binance at once. Or better said, that's how you can download all the currencies that the Binance supports at the given moment in time at once. And as is my usual, I just uploaded the entire project that I just created to my GitHub account. This is where you will find it. I also created a readme file for you. I think you will need to install only these two dependencies, the schedule and the urllib. Let me try this out one more time. Looks like it's working. And this one seems to be working as well. All right, that's just to try out if the keywords are correct. So, and this is how it looks like in my GitHub account. You will find the project under Tech Divisions, Python, Binance, Stream, all currencies at once. This entire project is a very good way how to find new currencies. So each time a new currency arrives, there is a huge spike in that currency. The currency rises a huge amount of percent per just one single day and then falls fast. If you manage to catch the race, then you actually make quite a lot of money with that. That's just an idea. Of course, you could also lose your money this way. So, and that's it. Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and if this is the first time you are watching one of my videos, don't forget to subscribe. See you soon.